the slopes of Sylacauga, Alabama, Mr. Jim Neighbors. Jim, where are your skis?
Oh! Well, I just thought I was coming over to sing a song to. I didn't know you was hosting the Winter Olympics.
Oh!
It's good to be safe and sound and back in the studio, but it was fun. I know that being in the snow is fun for another guest that we have on tonight's show because she owns a beautiful ski lodge in Stowe, Vermont, and she's very special to me because I had the privilege of portraying her in the film of The Sound of Music. Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome, please, Maria von Trapp.
Wonderful. This is a heat wave for me.
Oh, yes?
When I left yesterday, it was 28 below zero.
Oh, you must have been frozen, right?
Well, I'm thawing.
Maria, there's something that I've always wanted to ask you. Now, you know, I played you in the picture, and you are you, and I am me, and since you are you, and I was you, and, well, since you're here, and I'm here, and I was you,
Now, what do you want?
I want to know, how was I?
Huh? How was you?
Yes. Really? As you.
You were absolutely wonderful.
Ah.
But.
Oh. But what?
Remember that yodeling in the little goat herd?
Yes.
You know, Julie, there is yodeling and yodeling.
I was only yodeling. I see. Is there anything we can do about that?
Would you be interested if I show you a tiny little genuine little Austrian yodeler?
Yes, I mean, even after the fact, it's better to learn how to yodel properly, right?
The two of us.
All right, yep. Teach me.
Tri-a-ho-e-yodel-dee-yo. Tri-a-ho-e-yodel-dee-yo. Try. Tri-a-ho-e-yodel-dee-yo. Tri-a-yodel-dee-yo.
And I should sing that, right?
Yeah, please.
Okay. It seems to help clearing the throat.
Getting to know you, getting to know us.
the Sound of Music, I was climbing up the mountain to freedom with the Baron and the children, and of course the director yelled cut, and I want to know what happened to you after that.
After that, we arrived on the other side of the Alps.
Uh-huh.
In Südtirol, which belongs to Italy now.
I see.
The Dolomite country.
Yes.
And there we were, father, mother, 9 and a half children, 10s on the way.
Oh, yes.
And our father Wasner, our conductor and director.
Yes.
Yesterday we had been really rich people, not well-to-do, rich. And today we belong to the poorest of the poor because we were refugees. A refugee not only has no money, he also has no right.
No passport.
And that we really found out because every country only gave you about 5 or 6 weeks permission to stay. And so we had to wind our way over Europe from Italy to France, from France to Belgium, from Belgium to Holland, from Holland to Denmark. With the money we made by singing, because we had to earn our living now.
Mm-hmm.
And the only thing we could do well was singing. And so we turned a hobby into making our living.
I see.
At first we sang for birthday parties or for church or for a hot meal or for staying overnight. And then slowly we built up a reputation, and then usually it was time to go to the next country and start all over again. Finally we came to Norway, and there we were very lucky. We got, seats on a boat?
No, a passage on a boat, I guess.
Passage on a boat?
Yes.
For the 11 and a half of us. And it was on the way to America. It must have been the first cousin of Noah's Ark, because it took 22 days to get there.
Oh, my goodness.
But that was lucky for me, because my husband, on the very first day, informed me that people nowadays talk English in America. And then he, on the line of helping me, he said, nothing to it. You can learn English in 24 hours. All you do is learn 1/24 every hour. So he taught me one sentence. He said, in order to pronounce a WH, which is a sound we don't have in German,
yes,
I have to blow myself up. And then he taught me to say, if I want to know the name of a thing, what is this? So I walked all over board ship, and I asked everybody English speaking with a pencil and pad, mm-hmm, what is this and this? And I wrote it down in my own phonetic spelling. And on the third day, a young doctor came and said, lady, you'll never learn English that way. By learning words, you have to learn phrases. Like, for instance, if somebody is very nervous and you want to calm him down, just say. Or if somebody is in a room and you want him to leave quickly,
mm-hmm,
just say. Okay, so I learned phrases. And a very short time after we were on our first American concert tour, outside of Chicago, we were in a small college which was run by sisters. And there was a tiny reverend mother, and she was walking up and down backstage, and she looked so nervous and so flushed. And in that moment I remembered, somebody is nervous. So I walked over and I said, Reverend Mother, please keep your shirt on. She did. And a few days later, we were singing in a big town south of Chicago, and it was a Sunday afternoon concert, and the bishop was there.
Mm-hmm.
And afterwards, the bishop invited us for dinner at the bishop's house. And after that dinner, the bishop and I met at the door, and the bishop motioned me to go first, and of course I knew better, so I motioned him to go first. And for a little while, silently, we motioned. Until I suddenly remembered, if someone is in the room and you want him to get out quickly. So I looked up. The bishop was 6'6". And I was drenched in respect when I said, please, bishop, scram. And I said to Julie, as from one Maria to the other, with love and admiration.
Oh, Maria, that's lovely. Thank you.
And this is my autobiography.
Yes.
And it's an honest book. See, all this, the real Maria from The Sound of Music, you see, I was so fed up with this. So I really wanted to come back as my real me, with all my mistakes and all my faults. And I share here a few very important mistakes I made, hoping people who read this won't make them.
Well, I'll then be making a movie of this next, Maria.
Yes.
Listen, one of the favorite things that I experienced about making the film, I think if I had any memory that I loved the most, it was the mountains and the scenery.
Around Salzburg.
Around, you know exactly what I was going to say.
The first 10 minutes of the film, I could see them every day for breakfast.
I'm glad you liked it. Well, how about seeing them again over tea?
I'd love to.
All right.
Beautiful mountain.
It's a shame we don't have the piece of film with Maria on it. We couldn't get it, unfortunately, Maria, but she is in the film, believe it or not. You know, it's nice to talk about Salzburg again. It's even better to have the chance to see it. Watch again. But tonight, would you do me a favor and just be yourself and sing with me?
I'll try.
I'm sure you don't have to do that. Let's sing Edelweiss.
Edelweiss.
Yes, it was one of my favorite songs.
My kind of people. I kid you not. I kid you not. But seriously, audience, may I call you audience? Thank you. Thank you. I must tell you that tonight, you know, right after Julie, I've got a great show. That Scout's Honor. Scout's Honor. But please watch. I'm going to show some home movies of 600 lion cubs destroying my home. Demolishing it. And then we're going to see some home movies of Robert Cummings when he was much older. And I swear this is true, I'm going to show some home movies of my home movies, you see. It'll be kind of like a double thing. I don't know, you know, I don't know why they call it the Jack Parr Show. It really should be called the Movie of the Week. I kid you not, this is all true. But right now, stay tuned for the second half of the Julie Andrews Hour, which will continue after station identification. Honestly, I kid you not, I never lied to you.
Too big to ignore, and I know too much to go back and pretend. Cause we've heard it all before, and we've been down there on the floor, and no one's ever gonna keep us down again. No, not again. Yes, I paid the price, but look how much I gave. have saved those left on the breeze. But here's that rainy day. Here's that rainy day they told me about. And I laughed at the thought that it might turn out this way. Though April shower every time it rains, makes it rain your way, and is from heaven. They bring the flower, don't you know, each cloud that blooms. Keeps raining all the time. Life is bad, and misery everywhere. Stormy weather, just can't get my poor self together.
Looks like a picture of my uncle's farm from about 10,000 feet up.
I beg your pardon?
That picture you're looking at, it's kind of confusing.
Oh, it's an early Picasso.
Well, I guess it's just not my cup of tea, but they sure do have some pretty pictures around here.
Yes, they do. I could spend the whole day here.
I have spent the whole day here. I was just looking at that there Mona Lisa.
Oh, the lady with the mysterious smile.
She looks just like she does in her photographs.
Well, I guess, come to think of it, she does.
If I'm not being too far, would you like to share my sandwich with me? You look a bit peaking.
That's very kind of you, but I think they have a rule here about eating in the Louvre.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, maybe I shouldn't eat it then. I sure am hungry.
I tell you what, I'd be delighted to share the sandwich with you. I expect the guards are probably out to lunch anyway.
Well, good.
Thank you very much indeed.
I'm on a tour of Europe, see? 21 countries in 21 days.
Oh.
Can't afford eating all those fancy restaurants.
You must be exhausted.
Well, I am mighty tuckered out. Yesterday we was in Copenhagen, and tomorrow Rome. My laundry's in London.
Oh, poor thing. Why don't we sit and rest ourselves on this bench?
You know, I've been wanting to sit on one of these things for hours. I thought they was works of art. Say, you really are a nice person. I've heard that a lot of people around here don't really take to Americans.
Oh, well, I'm not really from here. I'm from Birmingham.
Birmingham?
Mm-hmm.
That's where I'm from.
From Birmingham, England?
No, I'm from Birmingham, Alabama.
Oh, well, they're sort of sister cities, aren't they?
Well, then you might say we're related.
After a fashion, yes.
Well, cousin, my name's Claude Wilkins.
How do you do, Mr. Wilkins? My name is Cora. Cora Weatherford.
Well, I sure am pleased to meet you, Miss Weatherford. I mean, you sure do talk nice. I mean, it's real English and all.
You have a fairly authentic American accent yourself.
Well, but it doesn't sound as cultured as yours.
Oh, that's just because where I grew up, everybody spoke the same way. Now, if I had my druthers, I think is what you say, I think I'd rather speak like your Katharine Hepburn.
Well, if I had my druthers, I'd druthers speak like your Richard Burton.
Ah, what we are. I guess all the wishing in the world won't change that.
Yeah, that's for sure. There's no changing that, but... You know, I sure would like to be someone else. I mean, I'd like to meet a real pretty girl and kind of sweep her off her feet. I guess that sounds sort of crazy, don't it?
No, not at all. Sometimes it's easier to do that, to have crazy dreams and think you're someone else. Tell me, what do you do, Mr. Wilkins?
Me? I'm a shoe salesman.
Oh, well, that sounds like an interesting job. I mean, everybody needs shoes.
Right, you know, and... Well, what do you do, Miss Weatherford?
I'm a secretary. Yes, that's what I am. I'm just a plain, ordinary secretary.
Well, I bet you're just about the best secretary there is.
Oh.
Well, I bet you light up that whole office when you smile. Mm. You sure light up this old art museum here, and... Why, you don't... She don't hold a candle to you, Mona Lisa, and that's a fact.
You know, you certainly do know how to charm a person, Mr. Wilkins. I'll wager that you sell quite a few shoes.
Listen, if I'm not being too forward again, would you care to join me for dinner this evening? I mean, there's this little bistro over on the left bank, La Riva Gauchers.
I thought you didn't go to those places, and besides, you'd miss your tour bus.
Well, that's all right. The truth is that, actually, I'm not having much fun on this tour, and I've been kind of looking for an excuse to break away from the groove.
Well, I'd like to join you. You don't know how much I'd like it, but...
Now, don't think that I ask every pretty girl I meet out to dinner. The truth is, actually, I'm sort of shy, and it's just that, well, you're the first... real friendly person that I've met in a long, long time.
Oh, that's nice of you to say so.
And then maybe we could go up to the top of the Eiffel Tower and look out over the City of Lights.
Oh, I haven't done that in years.
And later on, we could go trip the light fantastic. Actually, with me, though, it's more like fantastic tripping. Then we could walk along the Seine and watch the sun come up.
You know, you're a very unusual person. I mean, you make me feel like a schoolgirl again. Chance meeting in the Louvre, sunrise walks along the Seine... Mr. Wilkins, I have to tell you something.
Well, yeah, I wanted to tell you something, too.
Mr. Wilkins, I know this sounds very, very silly, but I had an appointment and I had completely forgotten all about it. Would you please forgive me if I don't join you tonight? I would have given anything in the world to have dinner with a shoe salesman from Birmingham, but I'm afraid it's just not possible. It's been a great pleasure meeting you, and I want to thank you for the sandwich. Goodbye, Mr. Wilkins.
Goodbye, goodbye, Miss Weatherford.
Excuse me, sir, but we'll have to hurry if we want to get to the airport.
Yeah. That was some girl I was talking to.
I wouldn't doubt it. How did you get to meet Princess Beatrix?
Princess who?
Princess Beatrix. You mean you didn't recognize her?
Well, how about that? A real-life princess. She sure had me fooled.
We must leave, Mr. Wilkins. The limousine is right outside. I've brought along two papers for you to sign on the oil merger, and the Secretary of the Interior would like you to phone as soon as possible.
Okay. Let's go. By the way, Crenshaw, you know, if you ever really want to be happy, don't try to be anything but what you are.
Yes, sir.
You all are just a glorious little old dancer.
It's my pleasure, Miss Mandy, but right now I'd like to ask you a very important question.
Oh.
I want you to marry me. Now, I know that you and your father and your sister are going to lose Bellmead Plantation. Now, I'm a very rich man, and I can make sure that Bellmead remains in your family. I'm going to ask you one more time.
Mm-hmm. Mandy, there's a minister handy, and it sure would be dandy if we'd let him make a fee. So don't you linger, here's a ring for your finger. Isn't it a humdinger? Come along and let the wedding chimes bring happy times for Mandy and me.
But before you go any further, I want to get something straight immediately.
What's that, Miss Mandy?
If I've told you once, I've told you 100 times. My name is not Mandy.
I know that, but nobody ever wrote a song about a girl named Daphne. It'd be pure heck getting a rhyme for a dumb name like that. But I'll call you anything you like, just as long as you'll marry me.
Well, if I do, Beauregard, you know it would only be for your money.
I know that.
It would be a loveless marriage.
I know that.
We'd have to have separate rooms.
That's all right.
In separate houses.
That's all right.
In separate states.
That's all right.
Well, why in the world would you want to marry me?
Well, from time to time, we could get together for a song. I love the way you sing.
Well, it might just work, Beauregard. I suppose it's possible that I could make believe I love you.
Only make believe that you love me.
Peace of mind in pretending.
Couldn't you?
Couldn't I?
Couldn't we?
With you.
Well, a waltz wasn't exactly what I was thinking of. Where are all my other bows?
Here they are. Ring, ring the banjo. I like that good old song. Come again, my true love. Oh, where you been so long?
Ring, ring the banjo. I like that good old song. Again, my true love. Oh, where you been so long?
Now, what was it you were saying?
Oh, nothing. I guess I might as well talk to a wall as talk to y'all. Well, I guess there's nothing left for me to do but sing. Could you help me, Beauregard? Watch it there, Beauregard!
She's in love with Rhett, the butler?
That's right. I read the what? I'm sorry, Daphne. I've been blind and I've been a fool.
Oh, Red.
I want you to marry me, if you'll still have me. And then I'll work with these two big ears to rebuild Bellme.
Oh, you mean you'll work in the cotton fields?
No. I'm going to play the piano.
Red, you can't play the piano.
You see what love does to a man?
Well, I guess that leaves you and me out in the cold, Miss Lydia.
But Beauregard, I love y'all.
You do?
I've been telling you that for years.
Well, you realize that if I marry you, Miss Lydia, it'll only be so as I can be close to your sister.
I know.
It'll be a loveless marriage.
I know.
We live in separate rooms.
That's okay.
In separate houses.
Well, okay.
In separate states.
All right.
Then why in the world do you want to marry me?
Because you're from Dixie!
When sun goes down and the tide goes out, the people gather around and they all begin to shout. Hey, hey, I'll go find it. It's a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. It's a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud.
What a dance do they do? Glory, how I'm telling you. They don't need no band. They climb like clap their hands. Let's have your cow chewing on a gun. So waltz in the south and waltz at the mouth of the Mississippi. Waltz in the south, yes, waltz in the south and the north. You are.
Musical group Wings, starring Paul's first television special, James Paul McCartney, Monday night. Raymond Burr stars as Angelo Roncalli, who saved many Jews from the Nazis during World War II, and later became Pope John the 23rd. See Portrait of a Man Whose Name Was John, Sunday, April 22nd.